This video is for an individual by the name of JangoSwords or JangoSwords. Recently, I've seen your video. Somebody pointed it out to me. And what was really touching was the fact that you don't have a formal school, but you had the courage to show your capacity or your capabilities of spinning the sword and doing the best you can with what little you do have. I understand that you don't have a formal school near you, so that you can't get the right guidance. And it would be my humble pleasure to assist or guide you in a few tips so that you can practice at home. With what little I have, I'd like to offer this to you. Not only to you, but all the rest of the people out there that are in similar situations just like yourself. So allow me to share what little I have with all of you. While watching your video, I saw a lot of this action, like you're spinning a bowl. And when you're using the sword, you never put your hands or fingers at the edge of the blade. And as you turn it like this, you would get your fingers severely cut. So for you not to get unnecessary criticism, let me show you how I turn the sword. Now let's begin with safe ways to spin your sword, okay? A lot of people think that spinning the sword is a wasted move, but they don't understand that Korean swords or jingums used to have tassels that work as distraction. And with the tassel, by spinning or doing these so-called wasted moves, they didn't understand the tassel would distract or confuse their opponents. But let me show you the first basic spinning move from this position. Your bottom hand, palm faces up. You drop the sword and bring it completely to a full circle, and then your hand goes back up here again. And this is your safe way to spin or rotate the sword. Okay? Now, if you want to go to the opposite direction, your thumb has to go over to the other side. Bring it over, cross the arms. Cross the arms like this, and your palm has to push over, and you're in this position. One more time from here, pushing it over like this. One more time here to here. Okay? In battle applications, when you're doing this, here, you can also uppercut and bring it over and come straight down. When they're confused by the tassel, you can do many, many things, but your proper grip and execution is very important. Watch very carefully from here. I do this motion, I can pull up, and I can come around and chop down, okay? Now, another move, the first move is here, doing this, bringing it all the way over. You can also chop down in this position, which is a cross-hand position, or you can completely, by switching over the hand, come down in a full grip position. So it looks like this from here. This is a cross arm cut down, and this is a complete cut down. So those are your two ways to spin the sword safely without touching the edge or the blade. One more time, from here. Palm up, complete circle, make the grip, switch the hands, come down. And the second one, use your thumb, come to the other side, come all the way down. As your hand crosses over, you push up, you push down, and complete the rotation and come down. One more time, up here. This way, and this way. Okay, those are your two safe ways to rotate the blade